Authorities in Nova Scotia are continuing the difficult task of investigating the shooting rampage. There are 16 crime scenes, and experts say this may be one of the most complex police investigations the country has ever seen. Tom Murphy has those details.
The work is meticulous, sifting for clues in a mass killing. The task, extraordinary by every measure.
Pick your variable. The scale of this tragedy and the number of victims, the distance covered, the duration of time, the impersonation of a police officer, convincing impersonation.
That disguise allowed the killer to extend his rampage through 90 kilometers of rural Nova Scotia. It also put this case in a unique category for investigators.
You'd have to actually go back to the St. Valentine's Day massacre in Chicago in 1929, when Al Capone's men, dressed as both detectives and uniformed Chicago police officers, used that that pretext to line up rival gang members against a wall and shoot them.
So, one of the most pressing questions, did someone help him with the car?
And this was something that was professionally done. Did he hold himself out as a police officer when he had this done?
With the shooter dead, there will obviously be no criminal case. But the question of exactly how he did all this will continue to be examined from every angle, complicated by the number of crime scenes, 16, some of them burned out homes.
Fire scenes take an extensive amount of time to sort through all the debris, if it's a shooting scene, the shell casings, and then you want to make sure as well that you do get all of the remains.
Medical examiners are now reviewing some of the remains, hoping to bring some comfort to the families. Did their loved ones suffer? Dr. John Butt was Nova Scotia's medical examiner during the Swiss Air disaster.
What is important to the families is to know as much as possible that there was no suffering. That sounds trite, but that is important to the families.
And determining whether someone burned to death or died less painfully by carbon monoxide poisoning can take weeks.
So it makes things a little more difficult for people who are waiting for answers. That's a huge issue for the families, without question. The how quickly this death occurred.
And the question so many want answered, why? Experts say some questions will be easier to answer than others. Tom Murphy, CBC News, Halifax.